Okay. Here's what we are going to do. We count to three. Push me on two.
What?
Baby penguins, cute,
but ruthless.
Hello, welcome to Wet the Flick. We're going to talk about dancing penguins. Are you excited about that? I'm not. This is Matt Hatchety. I'm Christy Lemire. This is Alonzo Duralde. And the lovely Gray is behind the glass. Pristine, untouchable.
Where I belong.
Behind the glass.
In the clean room.
But she's going to talk about Happy Feet 2. If you can explain the plot of Happy Feet 2, I will be happy to hear it. Please go.
I'm really excited to talk about Happy Feet 2 because as I see it, Will and Bill are krill. They are suffering from an existential dilemma. They want to go away from their swarm and they want to see what's out in the world. So they go out into the world. They don't want to be herbivores anymore. They want to experience life and take a bite out of it, literally. Also, there's some penguins singing pop songs, and the ice shelf, wherever these penguins live, has blockaded these, says it's made them, see, I'm losing it now.
Very exciting.
What happens is,
it's hard
the environment is against our little penguin friends and have trapped them, and they sing some more, and then finally there's a penguin that's not a penguin who comes in and doesn't save the day. And basically, let's talk more about Will and Bill. Anybody?
Yeah, that's about it. You did better than I could. There's a trailer too that might help. Take a look.
What's a best friend for if he cannot bring a daddy and his boy together?
What can he do? He's just an ordinary penguin. Oh!
Sorry.
Uh-oh.
That's not healthy.
Two happy feet.
Happy feet too.
Okay, so it is it's an all-star cast, as it is wont to be with these types of movies. But yeah, the krill do steal the show, and they are voiced by Matt Damon and Brad Pitt, and they are the best part of the movie in a movie where there are many different kinds of movies going on simultaneously here.
Yeah, you know, here's the thing. I didn't like the first one, and people that I know who liked the first Happy Feet are not so into this one. I, as somebody who didn't like the first one and wasn't liking this one for the first half, something happens in the last act where I just kind of went, okay, this is so off the charts nutty that I'm kind of into it now. Like, after having to hear, like, you know, an entire tribe of penguins sing Rhythm Nation, suddenly...
Right. And do the dance, Janet Jackson choreography.
You know, suddenly, somehow, I don't know. I don't know what was going on in my head, but I went from being like, to suddenly being like, okay, sure, I'm in, I'll go with it. I don't know. I didn't retroactively then like the first half, but I still had a good time for the last act or so.
Yeah, there's a moment where it breaks into what could be Under Pressure, but it also could be Ice Ice Baby. And it's,
thankfully
it's exciting
they make the
there
right
for
choice.
A moment.
It's kind of a meta joke. Right, that was choice. Sort of this moment where I was like, oh, this is ballsy. You
and
know?
The entire theater held their breath. We were waiting. Alonzo, you had an early guffaw in there. But everybody was just going, oh my God, please don't. Yes.
There are like eight different movies going on here simultaneously. Yes, you have the global warming allegory. You have penguins and other creatures trying to find their place in the world. You have
daddy issues.
You have daddy issues. Yeah. And then there's this whole like Hurricane Katrina thing going on where they're all, because the ice shelf falls, they all get trapped and they're desperate for food and they're panicking and they're like trying to fling themselves out of it.
And then a plot line about somebody like masquerading as someone they're not.
Yeah,
and
they're like a cult leader.
Yeah, I mean, this movie's half-baked at best, right? The first one I kind of like up until the third act, and then it just gets weird and bizarre. This one, it's as if they took seven or eight different ideas, and they don't really explore any of them. Mm-hmm. I think that, you know, the dancing effects are cute, and the songs that they, you know, some of the songs are better than others. They're all performed well.
Pink takes over for Brittany Murphy now.
Right. I like the big, you know, the big number, you know, the Under Pressure bit at the end. Yeah. I like that they drop some Puccini in the middle of the movie. Yeah. Yes. That was funny. That was really.
That's when it starts to work.
And that was I think my turning point where I was kind of into it. And I like the elephant seals.
Yeah, you know, there are some fun bits in there, but for the most part, the movie's a mess. I think. But you know what? The kids that were in the theater I was at liked it. So.
Do you know the kids that were in our theater were actually screaming questions at their parents, which is exactly how I felt. And I think that when Alonzo, you're absolutely right. Like when the rest rest of the movie catches up to how bizarre Will and Bill are, then the movie gets tolerable, but it's just, it's almost unwatchable. Now, I saw like a behind the scenes thing where all of the actors actually filmed, they did the voiceover together.
Oh, interesting.
And
oh,
okay. Which is kind of
that
a new thing.
Because
it's very hard to record. However, it really did create an energy, but here's the thing, it left me just wanting to see the live action voice recording.
Right. So that makes know. Sense because like Matt Damon and Brad Pitt are friends.
Exactly.
So that makes sense for them to be like bouncing off one another in the same room.
And
right.
Pink
and
has
they
this,
have the funniest lines in the movie.
And no question. Yeah.
Pink has this great line in the in that piece I watched that was, she was like, I walk in and Brad Pitt just turns around and goes, welcome to the no shame zone. It's like, yeah, that's exactly what you created because I had so much fun watching it. I had no shame watching you either.
Well, you know what? There will surely be a Will and Bill Happy Feet 3. There has
yeah,
to be. You're setting it up for that.
Yes, and they'll ruin them, and right. I'm prepared.
Because a little bit of Will and Bill go a long way.
I was
going to
say,
guess.
Yeah, a 90-minute dosage, I don't know, that I'm dying
this,
for. And
but
by
this
God,
is like Puss in Boots getting its own movie.
Kind of, yeah. And two characters voiced by Robin Williams? Really?
One's more than enough.
They did that in the first one.
Well, it didn't work then either.
And you know what? There are all kinds of bad racial stereotypes thanks to the Robin Williams characters.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
But he gets to interact with actual Latino actors, so I don't know what that was weird.
All right, so two numbers.
Sofia Vergara mostly just looked creeped out. That's
in the thing you saw?
Yes.
Let's do numbers, please. Miss Gray?
I'm feeling generous and I love shrimp, so 3.5.
Alonzo?
I am literally split down the middle on this one, so I will say 5.
And you, sir?
You know, the kid vote has to,
yeah,
I have to put it a little bit higher, 5.5, because the kid, you know, this is a movie for kids, the kids like it.
All right, I'm giving it a 4. I'm right in the middle of all you guys. That's 4.5. Where is it, tomato-wise?
40-something.
Okay, so about
yeah,
the same.
So
we're
about right.
Not nearly as good as the Academy Award-winning original Happy Feet.
Which was directed by George Miller.
George Miller, who did this too, yes. Who also
brought us Babe and
The Road Warrior.
And, of course, Mad Max.
Of course.
Somewhere between
and
Happy
The Witches
Feet,
of Eastwick.
Somewhere between Happy Feet and Babe and Mad Max, the truth lies.
It's very confusing.
Will and Bill will find it.
Oy vey. All right, thanks, guys. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.
I said a hip hop, hip to the hip to the hip.
Pretty much.
Hip hop. Go watch the March of the Penguins instead of this.